Good afternoon and welcome. I'm Casey Cantwell, Director of Music and Organist here at Trinity. And it's great to see so many of you here. I suspect there are some Emmanuel people here today, and I'm glad you could make it. Really glad you're here. This is Rebecca and Chris's debut at Tuesdays at Trinity, but it will certainly not be the last time they come to Tuesdays at Trinity. So would you please welcome Rebecca and Chris Winston.
Thank you. We're so happy to be here. When we first started talking about this program, Chris said, you know, I think I'd like to play the Mendelssohn Songs Without Words. And I thought, oh, Songs Without Words, so what would go well with Songs Without Words? It says music about song. And so I thought, how about songs about music? So all of the pieces that I'll be singing are about music and obviously interspersed with the Mendelssohn. So we hope you enjoy. Thank you. this last vocal piece you'll see is from a group of songs called the Hermit Songs, which are written by Samuel Barber. And all the texts, it's kind of interesting, all the texts are medieval texts that were written by Irish monks and scholars and scribes, most of them just jotted into the margins of other things they were working on. Some of them are biblical, some of them are sacred texts, some of them are just little larks, one's about his cat. You know, just whatever, I guess if you spend a lot of time in a room writing, you'll write about whatever you think about. So in addition to having a wickedly difficult piano part, this one is clearly about singing praises to God.
Thank you so much for having us out here. We certainly appreciate the opportunity to come and play, and it has been such a joy and privilege to do this. I want to thank Trinity and its wonderful, wonderful staff for taking care of us. It was wonderful to hear and just to be able to say, well, I've always wanted to learn the songs without words, and why not? Let's do that. So we get to work together. If you've gone to music school at some point in your life, you know that as you become a major in your instrument, that typically accompanying people is your least favorite thing in the world because you're focusing on your degree. And I was getting a piano degree, and my professor said, you got to go play for 32 tubas. And you're saying, I'd rather die. And so they make us finish our juries a week before everybody else so that we can accompany people. And then you get a semester, and I don't know how it was for you guys in the back that went to music school, but in my school, you picked a name from the hat, and you could have had trumpets or singers, and then our professor would leave the room, and we got to trade like it was the stock market. Then we got to say, I have sopranos. I will trade sopranos for almost anything. So I'll take percussion, for God's sake, anything but sopranos. But as soon as I got out, I realized that accompanying was one of my favorite things in the world. And I've really had the privilege of playing with choirs and orchestras and things. And it has been a real joy for me. And I'm lucky enough to get to do it with my wife now for the past 30 years. So it's been a blessing. And thank you so much for letting us come here and do it. I hope you enjoyed this last one. This is Agitato. It's fast. And I think it sounds lovely in this room. So enjoy it. Thank you for having us. Thank you.